y'all. I'm Elizabeth, and I have a fun story to kick off this lesson today. So I show pigs at our local county fair, and at the county fair, you get lots of different questions from the public that come through the barns, and it's like really fun to get to talk to them, explain the swine project and agriculture. It's just really fun. But one of the oddest questions I have ever had from a person in the public is they come up to my pig pen, which has a pig in it, like you would expect. And they ask, what are the decorations on the pig's ear? And I look at it, I'm like, oh, that's an ear tag. We have to tag our pig to show them. No, they're like the little triangle decorations in your pig's ears. Whoa, hold up. I've never heard them called a decoration, but I can understand the question. So the little triangles that they were seeing in the pig's ears happened to be ear notches. Now, ear notches act as an identification for pigs. When you go to register a purebred pig, you need to have ear notches. When you go to sell your pig to customers, it's very helpful to have ear notches because you can look at the pig and go, this pig belongs to this mother and it is this number of pig in the litter. So today we are going to dive a little bit deeper into what ear notches are, how you ear notch a pig, and then we're going to practice our own ear notches. So to prepare us, get a piece of paper and a pen and get ready to ear notch a pig. So what are ear notches? An ear notch is a V-shaped notch placed somewhere in the pig's ear. Ear notching is done on newborn baby pigs for the purpose of identification. The pig's right ear is used for the litter number, and all the pigs in the same litter should have the same ear notch in the right ear. And the pig's left ear is used to show identification for each pig in the litter. When it comes to ear notching pigs, there are principles we must know about what part of the ear correlates with what number. So because we have the litter ear and the pig ear, they are both very similar, but there are their slight differences. The litter side can have much larger numbers because you are more likely to have a lot more litters on your farm than you do pigs per litter. So they both look fairly identical, so we'll start with the pig side. First, you need to split the ear in half, and then you will split it into fourths. So each section of the ear has a different number that goes with it. So this bottom section right here is the one section. This top section on the bottom is the three section. This upper section on the pig is the nine section. Now, the other side is very similar as well. You split the ear into fourths. This is a one, this is a three, this is a nine. But because you can have more litters on your farm than nine, and you don't want to put a lot of notches into the ear, you will have a 27 right here. And then at the very tip of the ear, we will have an 81. So as a review, in each year you have a 1, 3, and 9, and then on the litter side you will have a 27 and an 81. The litter number, each litter on the farm will have a different number, and then for the pig, each pig in the litter will have a different number. So an example may be 3, 1. 3 would be the litter number, and 1 would be the pig number. Let's meet our pigs. So our pig here today to help us practice our ear notches is Pig. She doesn't quite have a name, so if you have any suggestions, please drop the names down below. And our second pig with us is Bowser. So he's a cutie. We just bought these pigs about 2 weeks ago in the peak of the coronavirus. So while everyone was out quarantining, we were buying pigs because that's just how you do. So what do ear notches look like on a pig first? Let's try to take a peek at their ears. So if you look closely at those ears, you will notice that there are triangles in them. But when we look at the pig this way, we know that our right hand, which is this ear, but she won't stop moving. This year right here will be the litter number, and the other one is the pig number. So let's practice these ear notches. They're a little wild right now. So in this ear, we see a 9, 2 threes, and a 1. So 9 plus 3 is 12, 12 plus 3 is 15, plus 1. Her litter number is 16. And then in this ear, we see that it is 1. So here, ear notch is 16, 1. And say hi to the camera, pig. She is a sweetheart. I wish you all could meet her. So let's meet with our second pig, Bowser. So hopefully he goes over to start eating so we can talk. Go eat, Bowser. He likes to eat. So we know that this ear right here is the litter ear, and this ear is the pig ear. So on this ear, we can see a notch up here in the 9 section and a notch down here in the 1 section, which means his litter number is 10. And over here, he simply has 2 notches in the 3 section, which means he is pig number 6. So his ear notch is 10, 6. Say bye, Bowser. Now let's practice our ear notches on a pig. Let's meet Peach the pig. So we are going to practice with the ear notch 8, 5. First, we need to identify what number goes to either the litter or the pig number. Because we know how ear notches work, we know that the 8 is the litter number and the 5 is the pig number. But now we need to identify which ear goes with each number. So the ear to your left will be the litter number, and the ear to the right will be our pig number. So the 8 is the litter number and the 5 is the pig number. So now let's get to ear notching. Because we know the basic principles of ear notching, we know that the numbers go 1, 3, 81, 9, and 27 on this ear. So because it is 8, we know we need 2 3 ear notches and 2 1 ear notches for a total of 4 notches on the litter side. So it'll look something like 1, 2. With those 2 triangles, we have 2 3s, and then we will put 1, 2 to have 2 for the 1s, because 3 plus 3 plus 1 plus 1 equals 8. So that is how we notch the litter number if it were to be 8. So now to the pig side, the pig number is 5. And the same principles work for this side. We have 1, 3, and 8. So because the number is 5, we will need to notch 1 for 3, and then 2 for 1, because 3 plus 1 plus 1 is 5. So the ear notches currently on our pig Peach is 8, 5. So now that we have looked at what ear notching is and how we do it, what it actually looks like on the pig, and then I walked you through an example of how to ear notch, now it is try for you to try on your own. So what I am going to do is throughout the remainder of this video, I am going to put across the screen several different ear notches for you to practice on your own. So you will need to grab a piece of paper and draw a pig face like I did in the previous examples with the head and the ears. You know, you can jazz it up as much as you want to. So for example, I may put 8, 5, and you'll need to properly ear notch the pig for 8, 5. After a few seconds, maybe 30 seconds to a minute, I will post the correct answers in the video. Our first ear notch to practice is 4, 7. Once upon a young year, when all our shadows disappeared, the animals inside came out to play. We're face to face with all our fears, learned our lessons through the tears, made memories we knew would never fade. One day my father, he told me, son, don't let it slip away. Here is the correct ear notching for the ear notch 4, 7. Our next ear notch to practice is 84, 8. He said. Here are the correct ear notches for the ear notch 84-8. Let's remember that the notch at the very top of the ear is an 81. Thank you for participating in Ear Notching a Pig. I know it may be a little difficult at first, but thank you for trying. And on a second note, I know I mentioned something about my family going out to pig auctions while everyone is in quarantine. I just want everyone to know, first, my family is safe, and second, we are no longer going out to any public pig auctions as most auctions have been moved online. So we are all doing great in the swine industry of going out and social distancing with people. And finally, this is just my plug that obviously, we have been out, but agriculture must go on through this time. So agriculture is very important. So many of us agriculturists are still doing great work even through this pandemic. But thank you for watching today, and I hope you learned something new. Have a great day!